Hello, greetings family. How are you doing today? Once again, I'm here with you to share some basic tips, especially in this great business. For those of you that are yet to subscribe to follow me on this channel, I will advise you do so. Okay, subscribe so that you can get to know more on what we're talking about and how you can follow me on this channel. It will be a great deal if you will follow me. Okay, today I'll be treating something very important. Okay, a topic that I refer to as a very important topic. Now, well, in this our business, La Buena Vida business, you hear people tell you that they have been, you know, on this business for months, for years, and truly they cannot say this is the much success they have made. Now, but yes, but most times you find out that either they are busy doing the wrong thing or they spend too much time on a particular thing that are not that productive. So that necessitated this topic I'll be treating today. Okay, the topic goes thus: show me your timetable, I will show you a La Buena Vida success. Okay, show me your timetable, I will show you a La Buena Vida success. So today I'll be sharing with us how to prepare an effective timetable for use, even in our business. Okay, your timetable will determine the success you will get in this business. Okay, now I'll start by defining time, or looking at the word time. Time, of course, they say, time is precious. Okay, that time is precious is a known fact, but how come we never have enough time to meet our goals when we want to most times? Now, the popular phrase today is, I am very busy, I don't have time. Now, yet the person that is telling you is very busy, don't have time, is broke. You know, you begin to wonder, what are you actually busy doing? Because obviously you're broke. So what are you busy doing? Now, the truth is that such person has been hit by the bug known as lack of adequate time management bug. Okay, so that we'll be saying as we go on. Now, what are the facts to note about time? What are the facts to note about time? Okay, these are the various things you need to consider when it comes to your timetable and preparing time to do things. Okay, don't start your day until you have it finished. What do I mean by that? Before you start a new day, you must have made your timetable, your plans for the day. Okay? For example, in our business, your cell meeting starts between 8 and 9 o'clock, or 7 and 8 o'clock, or 10 and 11 o'clock, depending on the agreement or the timetable your team have. So you say 10 to 9 to 10 cell meeting, 10 to 11 invitation call, 11 to 12 this. You must plan your day. You don't leave it vague. Okay? Nature abhors vacuum. If you leave your time vacuum that you did not create what you're going to do, issues will come up. You will have activities that are not productive crop up and take up your time. So you discover that you waste the whole day. You get home or when you retire from the day and you begin to wonder, what happened? How did I spend this whole day? How did I spend my time? Because you truly cannot account for it, because you just finished an unproductive day because you did not plan the day. So don't start your day until you have it finished. So while you're preparing your timetable, plan your days. The number of hours in the day, the 24 hours, plan it effectively. Don't start your week until you have it finished. Don't start your week until you have it finished. Before you start a new week, plan it. This week is actually ending up, so by now you should begin to make preparation for the next week. So in your timetable, you must put in consideration how you're planning your week. Now, don't start your month until you have it finished. Okay? Don't start your month until you have it finished. And of course, don't start a new year until you have it finished. Okay? Work on yourself. Make sure you have planned what you're going to do for the next year. Of course, you don't just bump into the year, it's going to be my year of double somersaulting, double this, double that, and yet you did not plan any strategy or any timetable for the year. No, if you do that in La Buena Vida, you will fail. So plan your day, plan your week, plan your month, and then of course plan your year. Okay, now, how to develop and implement an effective timetable? How do you develop and implement an effective timetable? Now, there are various steps to doing that, so I'll be sharing some of the steps as we go. Number one step is step down to easier goals. As you're preparing your timetable, you need to step down on easier goals. Now, don't be too ambitious in setting up timetable. Don't be too ambitious. You want to achieve a whole lot of things. Start small and increase as you begin to make progress. For example, sharing of questionnaire, which is of course a major way of growing prospects in our business. Sharing of questionnaire. Now, if you cannot share 10 questionnaires in a day because your neighbor or your friend can share 10 questionnaires, you go and put 10 questionnaires in your timetable. You don't have that capacity. You need to tell yourself the truth. Now, if it is only 5 questionnaires you can share 5 questionnaires. If you can only prospect 2 persons in a day, prospect 2 persons. But as you begin to improve, of course, you can now increase. That's number one. Number two, work smarter. Become more skillful. Okay? Work smarter. Become more skillful. Develop your professional skills. It's not the number of hours you attribute to a particular task that matters. It's your efficiency in those tasks. And your efficiency is proportional to your skill level of that particular task. Okay? So develop your professional skills like prospecting, inviting, presentation, close down, follow up, or even starting up a new distributor, and of course, event promotion. Now, these are the skills. You must master them and then know how to apply them. Then so that when you are applying into whatever the task you're doing it more tactically like a professional and not spend the whole day on such. Okay? I need you to know that. Now, three, take charge. You must be in charge. You must be in charge of your business. It's either the business runs you or you run the business. Impose on yourself the responsibility of being in control of your business. Yes. Set up a timetable for yourself and be in control. I want to spend 1 hour on this. No Jupiter will change it. No distraction. Hey, please, I don't have time. Just let me finish what I'm doing. You are in control. You don't set up a timetable and back and forth, people toss you around. Then you're not ready. So you need to set up a timetable and be in control of your timetable, be in control of your business. That's when at the end of the day, you can actually beat your chest that you have been productive for that day. So you must be in control. Number four, reasonable time is enough time you need to achieve your goals. Reasonable time. Okay, not the number of hours you put in that matters, but what you put into those hours that matters. Not the number of hours. You can spend 10 hours and do nonsense. And you can spend 30 minutes and get good result that some people will not put in 5 hours. So you need to work out your time and be sure that you are applying the time effectively and you don't waste precious time. Okay, let's move on. Now, number five, write down and prioritize your goals. Write down and prioritize your goals. Okay, always consider goals according to order of importance. Always consider goals according to order of importance. Your goals must be time bound. You don't write goals and leave it open ended. I'm going to achieve this. I'm going to achieve this. I'm going to hit this target. I'm going to hit that target. And yes, you don't give it time. Okay? And then of course, you don't know what you want to put first. There are certain goals you must achieve before you achieve the next one. For example, in our business, okay, you need to have enough time to prospect. Prospecting is key because our business is about showing people our opportunity. It is not electronics you show the opportunity. It is not cows, it's not dogs, it's human beings. So you must prospect human beings. So in planning your timetable, prioritize when to show human beings. Give it time and give it energy. Now, then also, you need to also have a contact list And then the next thing is you must invite. Keep a time to invite. To invite enough prospects so they can see the presentation. Okay? So you must write it down and give it this order of importance so you can achieve your goal eventually. Number six, often review your goals. Often review your goals. Now make sure you review your goals periodically. Make sure you review your goals periodically, okay? And know the extent that you are going. Review your goals periodically and know the extent you are going and then the progress you're making. Now, if you become comfortable on a particular goal, you have become comfortable, you know, it's a walk in the park. For example, you assign that you're going to be sharing 5 questionnaires every day, and of course, you're hitting that target. In 1 hour, you're already done. In 30 minutes, you have mastered the art of sharing questionnaire, and it has become easy. So what that means is that you need to step up that goal. You have become too comfortable in that goal. And when you become too comfortable at a particular level or at a particular stage or at a particular thing for too long, because you're too comfortable on that thing, you know, you're no longer moving. There's nothing to challenge you. The next thing is that you start losing interest. And when you start losing interest in that thing, you start dropping. Okay? So you always need to upgrade yourself at every time. Now, if you are comfortable on that goal, review upwards. Review upwards and start a higher challenge. You're comfortable with 5. You can increase it to 8. You can increase it to 10 or 12. Okay? That way you're making progress. Or if you also realize that you're not comfortable with a particular goal you set for yourself. For example, you wanted to be doing 5 questionnaires every day. You have managed that for the first 1 month. You hardly could do 5. You managed to do 3, 2, 1, or even none at all. Okay? Maybe because of your discipline or probably your time schedule. Now, what do you need to do? You need to review such goal downwards. What it means is that you cannot meet up that goal. So review downwards. You can bring it down to 2. You can bring it down to 3. Or at least that's something that you can easily hit. Now, once you hit that new level, you can then upgrade again. So while you're doing your timetable, you need to review your activity daily, weekly, monthly, by 6 months, by 1 year, by 3 months. You know, just find a way to make sure you're reviewing what you're doing to know whether you're making the adequate progress or you are not making progress. Okay, that's about that. Number 7. Now, identify major and minor time. Learn to classify your time into major and minor time. Okay, don't major in minor things and don't minor in major things. Okay, now let me show you some things that should be referred to as minor time. Things you should give minor time. Things you should not spend so much time on. For example, in our business, now while you're preparing your timetable, you need to be considering these things. Okay, you want to set up a timetable for generating prospect. Now, writing contact lists or generating prospect lists. You now put 2 hours for, no, now that is a waste of time. Okay, what do you do? Things like 20 minutes, 30 minutes, these things are minor time. Things like keeping books on prospect. Now, if you don't keep books on prospect, I think you need to start keeping books on every prospect. The discussion you had, the agreement you people had, the promises made, the promises you even made to the prospect, you must keep the book. Thinking about prospect, that's number 3. While you're thinking whether I should see this prospect, whether I should not see, whether I should visit or whether I should not visit, you need to put them down and attribute minor time to them. Now, visiting prospect, okay? You need to visit a prospect and explain, you know, just to find a courtesy visit. This one is not a normal visit, not a visit of presenting. No, just normal courtesy visit. Hey, I just want to check on you. How are you doing? How is the family? Fiam. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, you're done. You move. Evaluating prospects. Okay, evaluate the activity and then know what to do, either to review upward or downward in area of your assisting them. Then the second one is major time. Things you attribute major time to. Okay, now basically in this profession, the things you attribute major time is is when you are in the presence of a prospect. Okay? When you are in the presence of a prospect, this you need to give time. You want to visit a prospect, you want to show a prospect the plan, you want to run presentation, you want to do follow-up, you want to do close down, you need to give such adequate time. Okay? And while you're going to the prospect, you must have a clear-cut agenda of what you're discussing with the person. You don't come to a prospect front and begin to you should have okay, I wanted to say, okay, no, you must have it in bullet points. You must come well prepared, and you must be a master, or you must master your skills. Okay, the following should be mastered even before you go to a prospect's presence. Number one is your scripts. You must have rehearsed and mastered what you're going to say. Don't go into a prospect present and just be blabbing. No, you must have your script and you must master it. Two, presentation. You must know how to do a presentation well. You must know how to present your company opportunity. Okay? Within the short available time available, you must know how to present it properly. Then you must master the compensation plan. Master your company's compensation plan. Don't go there and do a guesswork. Okay, master the company products. You must be proficient in close down. You must know how to follow up properly. Okay, so give adequate time to things like this. And also, while you are at all of this, be sensitive also. Be sensitive and don't mistake movement for achievement. Okay, don't mistake movement for achievement, and don't make mistake also to refer to as courtesy. Now, when somebody is being courtesy, you now conclude that the person has consented to your plans. No. Know when someone is just making a courtesy, being courtesy or being cautious with you and just being nice and say, okay, well, it's a good plan. Well, let me think about it. I'll get back to you. He's just being cautious. So just put that into consideration and then know how to marshal out your next line of action, follow up, or it's more exposure. But when somebody gives you consent, like, okay, great, wow, well, I have a few things on my plate right now, just give me tomorrow, give me next tomorrow, I should be able, you said it's 44,000, okay, great, give me like 2 days, I will be able to do that. Now, that such person has given you a consent. Now, what you now do is note that date, the exact time, and then when that day comes, call the person. So these are things you spend major time on, okay? You must be able to classify your major and minor time. Okay, number eight, adequate concentrations. You must give your business adequate concentration. Now, save work for office and then save your relaxation for when you're at home. Now, like some of us were like, okay, you're on your way to office and maybe one of the things in your timetable for that hour is maybe one or two things delayed you and you did not go to the office when you're supposed to go. But because you have on your timetable that you're going to start doing invitation call, and behold, you pick up your contact list and you start calling, start inviting people. Hello, my name is blah blah blah. I'm calling you from Labuana Vida Project office. Okay, you were highly recommended to us by so person. The normal invitation calls we make. Now, while that is going on, the person is hearing in the background of that call, along, along, along. You are in the public transport, or somebody is shouting, buy your pure water, but you know, in the background. Meanwhile, you told the person that you are in the office. What do you think you're doing? At that point, the person is, these people are scam. What is he saying? Office, and I'm hearing such background. Okay, or you go to church, for example, those of us that go to church, or in your worship place, it is not time. Maybe your worship, your church service was supposed to start maybe 6 o'clock, and you happen to arrive there early by 5:30. Your plan is to use that 30 minutes to make calls before the church service starts, and you're sitting in the middle of the church, maybe at the back seat, and behold, you start making your call. I'm calling you from Laguna Vida Project office. Okay, and this one, we highly recommend it to us. And behold, the choir people are preparing for their meeting. the church service, and they are testing the microphone. Hallelujah, testing the microphone. And somebody is hearing it from the background, and you claim you are in the church. You know, this thing. So you need to learn to concentrate. When it is office time, keep the work for office. When it is time to relax or home time, don't do office work at home. Okay? You need to learn to concentrate and differentiate what to do. Now, number 9. All work is good. All work is good. Now, you don't have to have passion for every work or job given to you. No, you don't have to. No, I don't like this thing. I will not do it. No, it's not for me. Mm-mm. You don't need to like it. What matters is that you are doing it and you master it properly, because that is where your daily bread comes in from. So you don't joke with it. I don't like this and I'm not doing it. Hunger will show you. For example, sharing of questionnaire or going out to prospect. Some of us hate it with a passion. But because that is the raw material you need for this business, to grow your business, you must prospect. You don't like sharing questionnaire, who cares? Go and share it so that you can get prospects that you will invite to see your opportunity. So you must prospect. Okay? You mustn't like it. The most important thing is that you're going to get results at the end of the day. So you must go ahead and do it. You don't have to like the job. All job is good. As long as it brings food on your table, all legitimate job, I must say, is good, as long as it will bring food on your table. So learn the job, master your skill, so that you can perform well at it. Now, number 10, learn to say no. Learn to say no. The reason why most of us are struggling that much is that we don't know when to draw the line. You don't have to be nice all the time and say yes to every request at the detriment of losing your valuable time.